ABC News exclusive with pop superstar Ariana Grande. She's opening up about how she's moving forward from that deadly attack at her concert in Manchester. In the emotional moment, she decided to return to the stage. It's been over a year since Manchester.
Yeah.
And a lot of people thought you weren't going to perform again.
I didn't think I was going to either.
It was 10:30 p.m. on May 22nd. Ariana Grande had just finished her sold-out concert for 20,000 at Manchester Arena when an explosion rocked the stadium. Inside the crowd, many young children and teenagers with their parents racing for the exits. Outside, mayhem. Police later confirming a suicide bomber had killed 22 and injured hundreds. You've been very open about your struggles with anxiety. Yeah. So how did you overcome all of that and get back on stage?
Well, I think just looking at my fans and the way that they responded to it, and like, of course, the city of Manchester and how they responded to it with so much like unity and strength and love and like fearlessness. And I just never really seen anything like it. And I was like, you know, that's not the reaction to have, is to like recoil and just like go away, you know? Mm-hmm. So when we like decided to continue my tour, because I went right home. I went to Florida and I was like, I can't. I was like, I'm not putting those costumes on again. I can't sing those songs again.
You were
like,
done.
I was like, I can't. I was like, I love y'all. I can't do it. I was like, there's no way. And then I was trying to go to sleep that night and it didn't feel right. It didn't feel like the right decision. I think we should set a better example and kind of like celebrate their lives, you know what I mean? And try to like not let hate or like violence or any kind of darkness of that magnitude win in the scenario.
Manchester, I love you with all my heart.
Returning less than 2 weeks later for the One Love Manchester concert, Grande and a host of stars took the stage in front of more than 50,000 joyous fans.
I think a mixture of just like the love from my fans and like seeing people be there for one another and help each other heal, and therapy and time, everything, you know, you find the light eventually. And it's still, you know, a work in progress, but I think the sense of community that I saw in response to what happened was the best example of humanity.
And I really enjoyed my time with her. She is very open about what's going on now, very happy. And she talked about the inspiration about her new album that's coming up. It's called Sweetener. She's very sweet yesterday. And also planning her wedding with Pete. Anytime you talk about Pete, you talk about a wedding, she just smiles and gets so happy. And that's
so
coming up.
There.
Yeah, he was there.
He crashed the interview.
But you're going to ask the question, are they already married? That's what some people want to know.
You want to know that.
I really nosy one here.
You've been on me all morning about it. Are they married yet? You have to watch to find out.
I can't wait to watch it.